Now, what was I doing? I was trying to find Rosa, right? I have no idea where she is. For now, check out the second masterpiece. Alright guys, welcome back to Let's Play Omori. Let's check out the second masterpiece. Oh, that's actually a lot better. People with fruit. This is very much like basic, like, you know, them posing a certain way, and so you do it with fruit and whatnot. But like, it's really way better than anything I could ever do. People with Fruit by the great artist Rococo. Behold my improvement. However, it is plain that I am still a student. I must shake off this novice energy for my next piece. Well, are you happy with my masterpiece? Just so you know, as my skill becomes, 10,000, which I do not have. Oh, that's fine. I'm sure someone else will recognize a true artist when they see one. It's not that I don't recognize you, it's that I'm poor. You've already eaten 6,000 of my clams. I do not have 10,000 more. Noah. I will give one... Where the hell would Rosa be? Where would she be? Is she here in the castle? Is she in another world? I don't know. She's sitting around Sprout Mole Village and I just didn't see her for some reason because I'm blind. She's specifically in the village? Alright. I mean, you know, things be that way. I'm gonna have money. I could get money right now if I really wanted to, but I don't have money right now, and that's sad. Where would she be? You weren't here before. Rosa, the jig is up. I'm pretty sure you were not the one in this room. Were you? Oh, maybe I'm no. She's not standing at the door, what? Why are you here? I'm angry, go away. Thanks to you, my dear sweetheart, ran away with that blasted Captain Spaceboy. Again! Sweetheart was only a few doors away. But now she's flown galaxies away. How will I follow her now? Do I look like I can fly to you? I don't know if that's really our fault. Rosa? Rosa, we know you stole Pessy's thing. Now give it back. This again? Why are you always after my sweetheart merchandise? I found it fair and square, so... It's finders keepers. Don't worry, guys. Let me handle this. Hey. Rosa, why don't you and I try to work something out? Ew, no, I don't want to hear it. There's no way I'm giving you the most valuable new addition to my collection. Now get out of my house. Kill? Maybe? No. Well, I know where it is now, so maybe I need to go back and talk to... person? Or talk to a thief? Heh, Rosa's being difficult again, huh? Figure, she's always been like that. Here, take this and show it to her. There's no way she will refuse you after seeing this. Blackmail. Now leave me and my new bed alone. Our business is done here. Well, that was nice of him. He didn't actually need to help us get it back. We just had him agree to help us find the thing, so... That was kind, I guess. Back again? You amuse me. Such a fruitless effort. Step aside, guys. I'll deal with her. Wait, kill. It's true that Rosa is a huge, real pain, but I have some serious issues with using blackmail as a means to... Hey, Rosa! Check this out! He'll put out the blackmail. Where did you get that? I've changed my mind. Please, kind sir, I'll give you anything you want. Just put my hand over that blackmail at once.
Yes. You want to pass this thing, right? Fine, whatever. Take it, it's yours. Now give me that blackmail. Hurry up and do it.
You traded blackmail for Pessy's thing. I love the interpretation that's literally just a black envelope. I'm gonna need you to get out of my house now. You already got what you wanted, didn't you? Now scram, scram, I say. Get got. What a huge pain. I should have read the blackmail. That would have been funny. Oh, well. I doubt you have the ability to, but it would have been neat. Oh, you found it, my precious thing? You gave Pessy's thing to Pessy.
Thank you, I say. Thank you, I say again.
In return for your selfless deed, I bestow upon you the ultimate gift. The ultimate weapon. You got a sweetheart bust.
Isn't it beautiful? May it fill you with joy for the rest of your days.
Oh, yeah. Just checking one thing before I continue. Who's... Alright. Let's see, just to be sure, is this a... Does not appear to be a accessory. Sweetheart bust. Deals 12 more damage, 30 less speed. A bust of sweetheart, it's really heavy. Like, really, really heavy. And 10 less hat. Okay. I don't care about this. 12 attack is not worth not only nuking my speed, but also my hit rate and my heart. I'd much rather use a body pillow. But we finally got through all that crap. Alright. I guess before we're done, let's head up here. Let's go tell this last joke, because I enjoy telling jokes. And then, I guess we should also head... You know what? Before we do that... Station... Let's go see if anything needs watering. I'm gonna water my plants. Omori gained 1 heart. Another heart. Anything for Aubrey, maybe? Aubrey definitely needs more hearts is the issue. Because she's constantly draining her hearts. Kel never gets any hearts from that. Omori gained another heart. Omori gets everything.
Okay.
I guess I can actually just walk into the forest. Because it is at the beginning of the forest. I mean, I typically water the plants. You've just been nagging me despite that. Hey, hero. It's your time. the bicycle joke. Why couldn't the bicycle stand up by itself? It was too tired.
That joke was so bad it made me want to...
Ugh. That one was actually bad, to be fair. I thought the other one was funny, I didn't think that one was funny. Oh well. I'm actually just gonna run back here to get to the end of the forest, because I don't feel like dealing with all the enemies in the forest. Just not worth it to me. Also, can I... waiting for something to happen? Anyway. Just wanted to see if I could visit back here. Bum bum. Bum bum bum. Just need to double check. Yeah, okay. It'd be very funny if I already needed water. Which I'm sure it's just a certain number of steps. Like, there's a random chance for each individual plant, so. There might be one somewhere I might be able to water, but it doesn't matter that much. I've almost been everywhere in the universe. Or have I been everywhere? I've been everywhere except for the underground area. The area across the water. The other side of the world. Alright. I guess let's finish this. Let's end the day. Let's do this. It's a long way down. Do you want to jump? Yeah. I can feel it watching me, but let's do it. This is a place they can't go. Oh hey, an Undertale reference. A white egret orchid in the language of flowers symbolizes the phrase, "My thoughts will follow you into your dreams." I wonder how I knew that. Stop trying to stop me. You find a book of interest. Read an excerpt. One by one, they fall asleep on the car ride home. It was a long day at the beach, after all, and everyone was exhausted. Blank was the first to nod off, then the rest. As the sun set over the freeway, Blank's head accidentally dropped onto Blank's shoulder. The sudden jolt wakes him, but he doesn't dare open his eyes. He pretends to be asleep and steadies his breathing. He listens to the sound of the road. He feels the soft sun resting on his skin, and the slight tinge of pain on his nose from tomorrow's sunburn. He is happy, very, very happy. And he makes a vow to himself that no matter what, he will remember this moment forever. Mountains of books forgotten through time. The keepers of this library have long since passed. Stop that. I said stop that. A white egret orchid. Always the same, huh? You find a book of interest. A puddle of juice sinks into the carpet. Hovering above it is none other than Blank, holding an open juice box. He looks around at his friends, who are all wearing the same face of disappointment. He lets out a guilty chuckle. In what it seems like less than a second, Blink disappears out the front door. A tiny black kitten makes her way through the stain, leaving sloppy, wet tracks all across the carpet. Blink's face turns red and yells for Blink, but Blink is already long gone. Blink's hands Blink some wet paper towels. It looks like they're the only adults here. And if they don't clean up this soon, the carpet is gonna stain. Mary and Hero, I guess. They'll have to deal with Blank later. If I had to guess, Blank the three is Kel then? Mountains of books, yeah. It was a hot summer day, and all Blank could think about was why they couldn't do this tomorrow. The backyard was a mess. Planks of wood were strewn about the area. Paint stains blotched the grass thanks to Blank and Blank's hard work. All day, Blank watched Blank lug planks of wood back and forth from his dad's pickup truck. He watched Blank hammer his fingers over and over and made note that over an hour has passed since Blank has climbed down her ladder. I will just be their moral support, Blank thought, as he sat sleepily in the shade of his favorite tree. Of course, he knew that wouldn't be the case. Soon his friends will be asking for his help, and he won't be able to refuse. The treehouse is for everyone, so it's only fair that everyone put some work into it. Blank knows this and agrees, but reluctantly. He slides up and wobbles his way to the mess. He knows he should put in his fair share. It just had to be on the hottest day of summer. Yeah. Memories. Hey, Mary. You find a book of interest. This year, Blank was lucky enough to get assigned to a desk next to a small window. Every day during class, Blank would gaze lifelessly through the opening, as the shadows of the tree, the clouds creeping overhead. His mind drifted elsewhere, into his own worlds, his own stories, his own adventures. He had a habit of doing this. It was easy for him to get lost. Today was the same as any other. Blank stared vacantly out the small window as the clouds passed one by one. Suddenly, a hand playfully slaps his back, snapping him out of his reverie. Blank looks away from the opening. Blank smiles, so that would be Kel. So one is Sunny, three is Kel. He motions that class is over and that it's finally time for lunch. It's pizza today, and they need to bolt out to the cafeteria before it's all gone. Sunny's stomach growls. He looks at the small window one last time. He would have to continue his venture another day. So, Hero is one of the fours, probably Mary's the other. Basil is five, and Aubrey is, I guess, six? Stop that. Is there anything over here? I always try to check the left before the right. It's sunset. A strange statue watches over the hidden lake. It might have meant something significant in the past, but time has made its engravings ineligible. Either way, it doesn't matter to the company visiting it today. They're only here to use it as a diving board. The brothers take turns jumping off the statue. Hero jumps first, then Kel. Then Hero again, then Kel again. The brothers gleefully urge Sunny to join them, and after some careful thought, Sunny warily agrees. Sunny shuffles up the statue and looks down at the moving water. He can hear his heartbeat. His ears begin to ring. His legs feel as if they would give out any time. He tries to focus on his breathing. He feels something crawling on his shoulder, and his eyes fly open to meet with those of a black spider. In an instant, Sunny loses all sense and hurls himself into the lake. Water fills his nose. He exerts his limbs, but the water is stronger. He's too weak, too helpless, or that is what he believes. Sunny shuts his eyes and waits for the brothers to save him. So I was already afraid of spiders, and I was at least partially afraid of heights. That may be the origin of the fear of drowning. You find a book of interest. Read an excerpt. Everyone is over again today. The special occasion is Saturday morning. From 7 a.m. to 11 a.m., a group of six friends eat a delicious homemade breakfast and watch TV together. It's the most enjoyable part of every week. Sunny looks at the clock. 8 a.m., 2 hours left. He would be able to watch with everyone else until 10 a.m. when his tutor arrives. Sunny grimaces. What he thought would be a rewarding hobby has been nothing more than a nuisance. Instead of watching the shows with the rest of his friends, he'll be the only one to miss out. If only he could watch the last hour with everyone else. If only he didn't have to play the violin. Something opened. Just curious if there was something up here or if it was something at the bottom. Alright, I guess I'll head down here and I'll check out the light. It's probably... Well, the L key is there. Do I check out the light or do I check out the L key? I guess I'll check out the light first. An old grandfather clock, a closer inspection. It doesn't seem to be working. I'll come back to you in a minute, Basil. L. Six keys left. Okay, so that opened when I picked that up, so I won't be missing that. It probably wants me to go there, so I'll check out Basil first. Hey, Basil. A grand piano. The word Omori is etched across the center. Ah, yes, some delicious fruits. Would you like to eat some? You feel better. Mary's picnic basket. Would you like to save? Yeah. A white egret orchid, yeah. I wonder what this is all about. Part of this shelf has been cleared out. There's a hole here. Look into the hole. Yeah. Let's look into the hole. Hey, Basil. Don't forget, it's in the toy box. This time I won't forget this, though. There we go. Meow. Waiting for something to happen. A tissue box for wiping your sorrows away. Nothing new. It's definitely welcome to black space. It's pitch black inside, you can't see a thing. I know the drill at this point. I still don't want to do it though. But nothing has changed. Not yet. For now, it's just in the dream. So let's leave the dream. Two days left. Hey, Sunny. Alright. And now we're back in the real world. So it's back to blue. We should not make children play through this game. That'd be a horrible thing. You have a new message. Hey, Sunny, it's Mommy. Are you doing okay today? You haven't been answering my calls or responding to my voicemails. If you keep ignoring me, I'll start to get worried again. I hope you're pacing your chores. I don't think I could finish everything in one day. I don't think even I could finish everything one day. Do you end up visiting Kel? If not, it's alright. I understand. Just take things at your own pace. By the way, can you check the closet downstairs to see if there's anything you want to keep? I'll probably just throw away whatever you don't want anymore. There's only 2 days left before I come pick you up. Okay, that's it for now. Mommy loves you. Bye, honey. I know, you don't need to remind me. I can play on my own. You brush your teeth. Your breath is now minty fresh. There's nothing here. That brush kills teeth. I refuse to go in this room. Even during the day. A refrigerator. I hear you. Empty. It's kind of fucked up that, you know, I was left here alone with, like, no food. Oh, hey, a pink spot from somebody spilling juice. That's crazy. Fireplace. There are nails stuck between the bricks. Hello? Hello? Sunny? Are you there? What would you like to do? Open the door. Get on the floor. Everybody walk the dinosaur. Hi, Sunny. Top of the morning to you.
Top of the morning to you. My name is Jack Septica.
Well,
More like noon, actually. It turns out Hiro's not coming back until around dinner today, so I thought I'd drop by a little later. Mom is having me buy some stuff at Faraway Plaza before he comes back, and I thought it might be funner if we went together. Do you want to come along, Sonny? Of course you do. Come on. Let's go!
Classy white mailbox.
Kettle smells? What the heck? What happened here?
Dang it, must have been Aubrey and the scooter gang.
Sonny, be honest, do I smell?
Damn.
Wait, hold up, Sonny. I know it's been a while since it's been over to my place, but might not. Now might not be a good time. Why not? Stop telling me no.
Trash.
Basil. Hey, Kel. Hey, Sonny. Sup, Basil. Nice to see you out and about. Are you feeling better after yesterday? Huh? Yesterday? What do you mean? You had a big stomach ache, didn't you? That's why you had to go to the bathroom? Oh, right. Yes, I feel much better now. Did you want to hang out with us today? Sonny's not going to be around for much longer, you know. I don't know. Maybe tomorrow. Sorry. Don't worry. You don't have to force yourself. We can always catch up later. Yeah, you're right. Okay, then. See you later, then, I guess.
Trash.
Hey, neighbor, how's it going? Hey, Kel. Oh, and who else is with you? Oh, wait, I recognize you. It's Sonny, isn't it?
Sorry, it's been a while. I think we only met a few times.
My family's always lived here, but I was sent off to boarding school for a few years and just came back about 3 years ago, I think? Hey, Sonny. Chris is my next-door neighbor, and she's really cool. She's the fastest swimmer in school. When she's in the water, people compare her to a mermaid. Or a shark. Or even a torpedo.
Oh, Kel, you're never short on compliments. Aren't you trying out for the junior varsity basketball team this year? I'm sure you'll be a shoo-in.
Nice. Well, I try. I've been playing every now and then with strangers at the park. I think I'm getting better, but it's still a little hard to tell. But if I practice basketball as much as you practice swimming, I'd probably have a better chance. Oh, I'm not that hardworking. It feels like fun to me, honestly. And besides, even though I love swimming in pools, I love swimming in the ocean even more. I love everything about the ocean, the beach, the sound of the waves, even the smell of the seaweed. Sorry, I must sound a little obsessed. That's totally fine. It's good to be passionate about something, isn't it?
I guess. Actually, I think this all started because I went to boarding school on an island and really enjoyed my time there. The ocean reminds me of the friends I made there. I hope maybe I can see them again one day. But for the time being, I guess I'll just be collecting seashells and stuff.
By the seashore?
You know, that story kind of reminded me of this, but Sonny is actually moving away from here really soon. Maybe you can give him some tips on how to handle moving away to a new place.
Oh, Sonny's moving?
Well, being away from my friends was pretty tough at first, but change is just a fact of life. Blah, 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 blah,
blah. I should drink something.
It's the memories we make with them that we should cherish. You know what? I just decided something. If you see any seashells, can you bring them to me? They're kind of hard to find around here, but I'll make sure it's worth it.
Okay.
What a lovely day for a picnic, an all-American mom. I brought my specialties, chicken pot pie, lemon pie, and, of course, my world-famous apple pie.
Okay.
You brought three pies, one of which is a meat pie?
Ooh, making patties is hard work, but once I sink my teeth into the tender, juicy burger, it's gonna be all worth it. I can almost taste it now.
Dear, pay attention. The patties are burning.
Oh, shoot. Thanks, son. That was close.
Just gotta focus.
You got trash. Oh.
Hey, pal, it's good to see you. These new recyclist folk have been showing up. They're making a real big change around here. This is the first time I've seen so many people take the initiative to pick up trash. Makes my job a whole lot easier. Ha ha.
Something about them feels a little fishy, though. I mean, yeah, they wear recycling bins on their head. We recyclists followers the holy bin, as all have littered, all must accept that they are trash. Reduce, reuse, and recycle. Yeah, that's weird. Get as much trash as possible. Hell yeah. Ba-dum, 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 ba-dum. Oh, I actually have the thing here. I wish I could view these, but I can't. Maybe I can find some of them if I talk to Aubrey or something. Maybe she took them. It may well have been ones that were important to her. Either that or they're ones that Basil took. Ah, you ate the photos. That makes sense. Yeah, I didn't figure, but... you know. Shout out to the idea that somebody would just give you a dollar for a bag of trash, though. Because I know nowadays people would just, you know, take trash bags out of people's bins and do that. Which is trash to do, but, you know. Yeah, no. Alright, I guess I should head up. Stop wasting time looking around. Let's see. I'm pretty sure we gotta stop at Gino's Pizza and the bakery and other mart. Lead the way, Sonny. As I was saying, can you believe in her... But then, that was the last time we, yeah. And then, honestly, I think that, yes, definitely. Well, they're here, sleek silver scooter. Doesn't want me to interact with it, that way it doesn't spoil that it's Aubrey, but that is absolutely her. Yesterday, while I was eating a banana, I found a cool overgrown lake area just behind the park. But soon after that, a bunch of hooligans and scooters rolled in and kicked me out. And to make matters worse, they even threw away my banana. I can't let a bunch of kids boss me around. I'm an adult now. A young adult, at least. Behind the park, you say? I'm gonna need to know that later, so I won't bother. For now... let's check out Gino's. There they are. Gino's pizza is the bomb. This one is disgusting, dirty, greasy-looking cheese pizza, just the way I like it. To be fair, the best kind of pizza is, like, the dirtiest pizza. Let's dig in. So. We're still able to go on our secret hideout spot today, right? Listen. No. Mainly because distance. I'm gonna bring my fishing pole. Made it myself. out of a cool stick and a jump rope yesterday.
Do you think it'll work, Charlie?
So we're gonna go to our secret hideout spot. Hangout spot? That's a perfect date spot. I'll be sure to bring one of my special ladies. Swimming. Sounds pretty fun. Well, while you're all fooling around being babies, I'm gonna be busy skipping rocks. I've been looking for the perfect rocks all week. You can try all you want, Kim, but you'll never beat Aubrey's record. Shut up, Michael? I don't know. Like any girls would actually want to go to the lake with you without you paying them. I told you to call me the I bit my tongue. What a loser. Master, are you hurt? You prefer this, Kim? Okay. What a bunch of dorks. My older daughter is coming home tonight from college. I'm sure she'll have plenty of tips about what's hip and cool these days. Can't wait to catch up with her. Oh my gosh, my crush is sitting right there. What do I do? What do I do? Breathe, baby. You've got to be cool. My wife keeps telling me that I'm getting chubbier and tubbier, but I just can't help myself when you live so close to Chino's Pizza. I really shouldn't get anything, though. Last night, my wife smelled pepperoni on my breath and got really mad. Hello and welcome to Gino's Pizza. What can I get for you? Hey, I'm here to pick up an order. I see. What would you like? Oh, I know. Would you like pizza? Nom nom. I think my mom phoned in an order for a hero sandwich this morning. I'm just here to pick it up. Oh, I see. You're the family that keeps ordering sandwiches instead of pizza. But it's on the menu, isn't it? Yeah, you're right. I guess so. Okay, I'll go get it. This feels like an East Coast thing. You know, I don't know if I ever told you this, but that's why my brother's nickname is Hero. You think it's because of some really cool reason, like he saved a puppy when he was a kid or something. But no, he just really likes sandwiches. Well, here's your Hero sandwich. Please enjoy. You got Kel's pizza order. Cool, thanks. Alright, we're good to go now, Sonny. I'm ready when you are. Now we just gotta get to the cookies from the bakery and other mart. Okay, before I do that though, pizza order. In order for a hero sandwich instead of pizza. Hey, Aubrey. My tongue. Sonny and Kel, what are you doing here? Don't you know it's rude to bother the people while they're eating? Ew, it's a nerd. We was alone. We got no business with you today. Pizza. Yeah, this is what we're doing? Pizza. Did I press A one too many times? Yeah, okay.
Hello.
Yeah, you don't have to talk to me if you don't want to. Hey, that's a pet rock you have there. If you're here, then that must mean you know about the veterans of Faraway Plaza. And if the shop keeps sending you, that means you must be pretty good. Well, here I am. Surprised? My real title is Gino, Clasher of Jash. Would you like to clash? Challenge me to a clash? In that case, I, Gino, one of the four veterans of Faraway Plaza, will show you what it means to be a real pro. Let's get him, little G. Are you ready to clash? Scissors. Rock. Do you do paper next, or do you do scissors? I'm gonna see if you keep that up. Do you do scissors now? And now you're gonna do rock. No, you broke the thing.
I'll do paper again. Maybe you're gonna do rock. Okay, at 1 HP, you just seem to do paper, period. Little G, speak to me! Oh, wait. You can't do that, can you? Well, that was a real doozy. Congrats on your end, though, Challenger. You and your pet rock did great. Maybe some of the other veterans would give you a bit more of a fight. You guys don't respond if I do anything with this, right? Sounds like a Toby Fox song. Alright. Pizza. Especially now. I'm gonna earn some money, actually. Let's work a job. So, I see you're peeking at the Help Wanted poster that I put there. You interested in a job? Cool. Let me help you get started. Are you taking this job, Sunny? In that case, I'll come back for you later. Work hard, yeah? So you wanna hear the good news or the bad news? I'll just start with the good news. So the good news is we got 3 different pizza orders today. Bad news is our Domer boy suddenly cold and sick yet again. Yeah, okay, so same as last time. Take this pizza to the house with the pink door and the light brown roof. Pink door, light brown roof. Almost certainly this, yeah. Pizza delivery! What took you so long? Gina's pizza's really sleeping these days. Okay. Please find the house with the... The brown roof and the something. The... Is that a T-R-E something? The something lined... Okay, I'm looking for a brown roof and something. I don't know. The red... With the twined... I don't know what this says. I'm looking for a brown roof with something weird about it. L-I-N-E-D. Something lined something. Car park. Is there a lined car? Like a car with a line on it?
You can't leave without delivering the pizza first. But I want the pizza. Brown roof? Yeah, it's a brown roof. That's very easy to see. Please find the house with the... tree wine... I have no idea what this says. Why'd I even try to do this again? Doesn't tell me what that is. Could be that. But the tree-lined car park. Okay. So this one, I guess. They call it a car park. Free pizza? Aw, you shouldn't have. You failed to deliver the pizza. Time to move on to the next order. It's not how that works. What the hell does that say? This pizza goes down the street to the house with the trees by the car park and the white car out front. Trees by the car park, white car out front. We're white car and trees. Maybe? It's the only white car I saw. So that's possible. I'll be real with you. Whoever made this sucks. If there's only one car, also, why did a bunch of these houses not even have paths or anything up to them? It's just lawn. Does no one go in and out of them? There's only one white car, so... yeah, it's not too hard on this one. The second one's what messed me up. Also, pick up your freaking cans. What took you so long? Yeah, okay. Also, what a piece of shit, just going, ooh, free pizza. Six out of 10. $20. So I got $10 per delivery? That's not bad. Sunny, I just remembered something. Do you remember when we were kids, me and you used to sneak out of the house to go to Hobbies in the middle of the night? We could never get up for school in time the next morning. Hero and Mary would always ask why we looked so tired. I'm sure they suspected something, but I'm glad they never told our moms. We were all pretty adventurous back then, huh? That's cute. Alright. Mine. Oh, hello there. I see, you're carrying a pet rock, so that means you want to clash. Oh, you know, us veterans are a bit tougher than your normal players. You still want to challenge me? Okay, come on, Akitako. I guess not the same as Taco Cat. Okay. Scissors. Ouch. Rock. Ouch. Good effort. You fought well, but I've been clashing alongside Nakataka for years. Just keep practicing, you'll get better, I promise. Yeah, let's rematch. Okay. Let's see if you do the same order. You might. You do not. Do you switch back to rock, or... The likelihood of you choosing rock again is very unlikely.
Damn!
So you have a higher likelihood of choosing rock than anything else from the looks of it. I gotta become the best. I don't even know if this matters, but it matters to me. And that's the important thing. I gotta be the best at Digimon. Okay, I have a 50-50 shot if I choose this. Do you choose rock again, or... That's on you. That's entirely on you for choosing that 3 times in a row. We lost? Wow. I'm really shocked. I guess Shopkeep was right to send you to us. You seem to have a lot of potential. I'm sure you'll go far. It's literally rock, paper, scissors. Like... Spend all of our money. Hell yeah. Alright, so let's donate the rest of these and see what they sound like. Chill, the brutal. And lively CDs. Alright. The chill. I'm Rai. Okay. Cover of Lost at a Sleepover by Omnibolly. Sounds quite different than Lost at a Sleepover, but I like it more now. I didn't like it at the beginning. Song. This is a cover of Underwater Prom Queens by Banshee Beat. It's cool. Not So Empty House by Toffee. Toffee? I like it. Worth 30 bucks to hear those, Blade. Alright, and now let's go over to Fix It and work a part-time job again. But beat you first. I see you're showing off your pet rock there. I didn't normally whip out my pet rock during work hours, but you must be really good if Shopkeep sent you. You ready for a real challenge? As one of the four veterans of Faraway Plaza, I have a reputation to uphold. If you're asking for a clash, I won't be able to going down so easily. Are you ready to clash? The answer is yes. I guess I'm doing rock.
Glad I did rock. And I'm doing rock again. And I'm doing rock again. That's on you, my guy. I made it very clear what I was doing. Oh wait, this must be some sort of mistake. Terry, how could we lose? Whatever. Back to work it is. Hell yeah. Speaking of work. Alright. Back to this stop and swap. I know how it works, don't worry. Okay, so wrench first, in place of the shovel. In place of, I'm not trying to, there we go. Let's do the hammer. Wasn't trying to, yeah, I'm mashing too fast. The shovel again. The drill. You know the drill. For a shovel. Wrench. Should probably just put the wrench where it goes. I guess the saw? Saw in place of a drill? Drill in place of a shovel, and I'm done with the shovel display. Okay. Drill again. The wrench. I know, this is just invigorating, guys. I know this is what everyone came here for, and it's why I'm supplying it. Need a stop button, you know, button mashing out of this. Alright. Let's do a wrench this time. Wrench in place of tape. Tape in place of a hammer. Hammer in place of tape. Which is in place of a hammer again. Tape again. Wrench. Hammer, drill, wrench, hammer, drill, saw. You see what you saw, you take the saw, and you're done. You're here for Sephiroth, okay. What? You're finally done? Excellent work, kid. Here's 30 bucks. Don't spend it all in one place. You got 30 bucks for your hard work. Hey, Sonny, how do you do? While you're working, I decided to play some basketball at the park. Man, that was fun. Well, I'm here. I'm ready to go whenever you are. Alright, I just got my 30 bucks back that I spent on those CDs. Let's go to the bakery. My mom placed an order there. Oh, even those people weren't real. Wild. Are you real? There's so many other types of tamales in the market now. I'm needing the fancy stuff. Okay. Am I putting food in my vehicle for sauce? Okay, I feel like I talked to all three of you yesterday and you said the same things. I cannot read. Joy. Okay. You don't understand anything they are saying. Hello, fish. Yep. I'm gonna need two, I believe. And work a part-time job.
Give me back the money I just spent.
Oh, you're gonna take this job? Cool. Yep. Fly swatting time. Oh, there you are. Let's get rid of the wasp.
I'm angry.
And I'm done. Where's my experience and money? Gosh. Realistically, I shouldn't even bother, but I'm gonna heal. Let's calm down, get over it. I'm angry now.
Face me.
Kill that wasp instantly. Ow. I don't know if I actually need to do any fighting today, so let's keep ourselves at about full.
And I'm angry.
Gotta keep myself as healed as possible.
Aubrey could attack me with a bat at any point.
And also other things could happen. I don't know, man.
I mean, keep on this.
Oh, right, that's how you get there. Is this a case where it's when I finish killing them all I'm done, or... Because I don't see anymore. Do I just need to talk to her? Good job. Took back the fly swatter. You got $20 for your hard work. Okay. Thank you for the money back that I paid for the fish. Fresh bread. Fresh bread. Would you like some fresh bread? That's weird, but alright. We've been running the bakery for 4 generations, ever since my mom sailed here from across the sea. I hope one day my children will be able to carry on the tradition of managing this bakery. It would mean the world to me and my husband. 4 generations started with your mom, and you hope to pass it down to your kids, so 2 generations. What?
Welcome to our family bakery. What would you like? I am here to pick up an order. Ah, yes. Your mother said you'd be coming, though I expect you to be here a bit earlier. I'll go grab your order. Did you know this bakery belongs to Mikhail's family? I guess you can't really tell because he wears that horrible yellow wig all the time. Seems like he's making a pretty big effort to stand out and be different. Here's your order, sir. Stop. Counterpoint. Fuck off. OneDrive asking me if it can do things. No. Here's your order, sir. We hope to see you soon. Please enjoy your baked goods. Yeah, Kale's bakery order. Hell yeah. Cool, thanks. Alright, we're good to go now, Sonny. I'm ready whenever you are. Candy? You doing any better? Probably nicer than the real one. Mincy is diligently sketching away. Okay. I don't need to buy any candy, so I'm good. Baked goods, check. Sandwiches, check. Well, that's everything, and just in time, too. Looks like the sun is about to set. Let's go back to my house. Hiro should be coming home anytime now. Already? I know I woke up at noon this time, but damn. This is a much shorter day than the previous one. An unassuming beehive. Let's do myself a favor. Award-winning pie. Yeah, I know I need to feed the cat still. Don't worry. Might have been in the parking lot over there. I wasn't really looking for it when I was over there. I was also looking for a way to save that was closer to up here. I didn't see one when I was over there. After seeing a cat on the roof the other day, and you know, have no idea what to expect. From the looks of it, it's always going to be the orange cat, specifically. An empty picnic basket. Yes, I would like to save. I'm actually going to overwrite file 4. The man who speaks in hands. What do the five fingers say to the face? Slap! Fine, I'll end the video. Stop telling me what to do, Grim. I can keep it going as long as I want. Fuck you. Alright. As Krim said, I do need to end the video here. I also need... So next time, we'll probably get through the rest of the day. Or at least most of the rest of the day. I need to say hi to the artist here. There was the guy who was fixing his plumbing or whatever. Or I don't really remember. You do, in fact, not make the rules. So I'm going to go say hi to people and feed the cat before I ever... And also take on that beehive, because funny. Before I ever head back to Kel's place. I'll see you all next time, and I hope you have a fantastic day.